This is pretty much an autonomous restaurant, save for one person, one manager who's literally managing the robots.
I look at the robots as humans as well, so I kind of think of them as my coworkers.
Aside from that one person, everything here is run by robots.
Some of them throw their tantrums, some of them have their issues.
White Castle and Jack in the Box are using these robotic arms and technology in their kitchen. With food costs surging, hourly wages rising for owners, and tech costs coming down, you can't deny it. Robots are coming for our kitchens.
Now you might be thinking, what about the human jobs? Companies are trying to eliminate the need to pay workers, and this is gonna be a bad thing for society. But many companies and restaurant owners will push back on that and say, we can't find people to hire, and if we do, it's gonna be so expensive that the cost to you, the consumer, is going to keep going up.
Okay, but then what? What happens to the more than 13 million restaurant jobs across the United States?
We're looking at it's probably $7 an hour. Yes, it is less expensive to operate Flippy than it is to have a human being doing that same position.
Nearly 10 years ago, McDonald's said it was adding its self-ordering kiosks everywhere. Not only do they streamline the ordering process, reduce errors, and just require less humans, but also customers actually tend to order more food when using a kiosk versus ordering with a human. Maybe customers are just less afraid of judgment with a kiosk. Who knows? But now we're seeing AI voice assistants taking our orders in drive-thrus.
I can see a pizza place. I can see a robot manufacturing pizzas easily. Add toppings, blah, 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 shove it through, spit it out.
But now restaurants are racing to use robots in the kitchens. So what's going to happen in the back kitchen?
I believe this is probably the future of the world, is getting robots to do just about anything.
But are these robots the future of how you and I will eat out?
I've come to Pasadena, California to come to this restaurant. It's called Cali Express by Flippy. Miso Robotics partnered with Cali Burger to launch and showcase Flippy as the ringleader in the kitchen.
A customer has just walked in. The customer has headed straight to the kiosk to place her order. Meanwhile, the only human worker at this restaurant, the manager, is putting on her gloves, standing by, ready to go.
The robots are fast. They do whatever they need to do, and I'm just the one trying to catch up to them, you know?
It's here where I meet the restaurant's only human worker.
The robots cook everything, I just put it together. So what I tell people is that usually they're waiting on me.
So this entire fast food restaurant only needs one human. And as you can see, the human is standing by. Sometimes when there's a lot of orders, everything is being held up by the human because burgers can be made fast, french fries can be made fast. So right now it says Flippy is waiting for a new order. Once an order is submitted, it'll literally tell me like 30 seconds until the fries are ready, 10 seconds, and then you'll see the robotic arm actually grab the fries, put them in this thing, and the fries will come out.
A customer places their own order on a kiosk.
They'll program it in here, and then they'll bring the food to them. There's no human to take orders. There's no cash accepted. It's all gonna be done on credit card. There is even a biometrics. So let's say you're a regular person here. You can come, it'll scan your face, and automatically it knows it's you.
Then automatically the fries go into production. And this burger patty machine spits out a raw burger to start grilling. And when the time is right, it flips.
So this robot literally just made the beef patty all by itself. No human had to touch it until the very end where it's gonna be added here.
We know that french fries aren't the only fries in the restaurant. So we have these area called the auto bins where a team member can place in the food, such as onion rings or something like that.
A human can put anything here like fries or onion rings, and Flippy will use AI to detect what it is, then know exactly for how long it should cook for.
Anything you need fried will be done here. A human will put food into the machine here. It'll go through the process, and then here is a timer.
Some cook for 2 minutes, some cook for 2 minutes and 5 seconds. You know, they're a little bit different. Everything has its own unique menu.
Afterwards, it can drop the grease just kind of like you would do manually cooking it. And the intelligence of Flippy, it's not just one basket of fries, right? It's all different menu items cooking at the same time, asking, how do I not burn something? Flippy is now introducing its third version.
That is 50% smaller. So this electronics equipment, the size and the space, we've used a bigger arm to be able to move and maneuver, but what we were able to do is shrink Flippy as much as possible.
This technology is getting more affordable. What used to cost maybe $50,000 might now cost $8,000 or $10,000. Restaurants can pay for the upfront costs of installation, then pay manual monthly fees.
If a brand decides, I don't want to pay anything upfront, I'd rather pay monthly, then it pays itself back in the first month because the labor that you're offsetting is that and other benefits.
Once the burger is prepared, there's even a robot to deliver the food to your table. Now, this movement has to be programmed in by a human, for now at least.
If you want condiments, napkins, ketchup, you can do that yourself. You don't need to talk to anyone. Even something something like this, this is gonna be the waiter, the server, that will actually bring your food from the kitchen to the table.
So what is it actually like to be the only human working here?
I think it's really fun. I look at them as my coworkers, so we work together to bring out good food.
Quick break to show you something. Aura will show you if your information is leaked on the dark web. I actually know so many people who have been hacked lately, and Aura is a great way to protect yourself. I've been using Aura for a while now. Robert Downey Jr. is on their board. You can scan right now to see if you've been exposed, and check out the link below to save over 60%. You can protect yourself for as little as $10 a month. Okay, now, back to the video.
Burns, cuts, slips, and falls, these are extremely common issues amongst food workers that you might not even realize as the customer.
Since I started at a bakery, I used to get a lot of burns, but now that I'm working with a robot, working the fryer, I don't really go home with any burns.
The manager tells me that despite seeing all this automation, well, it's not always seamless.
Sometimes they'll throw a tantrum or they'll be too stressed out and they're stopped working. And it's just working around that and just being able to troubleshoot and diagnose what I have to do.
Miso Robotics insists that this technology is good for everyone, and that this is not just a matter of cheaper costs and replacing human workers.
It's helped because it offsets and gives to repurpose the labor. So it's not just the fact that labor is very expensive, but it's also that there's a labor crisis. You can't even find labor.
She's not totally wrong. More than one in three restaurants have had to limit their hours of operation because of staffing issues. See, currently the U.S. food service industry has 1.2 million unfilled positions, and there are 25% more job vacancies in restaurants today than before the pandemic.
So even if you do find labor, do you really want them to do the task that's the most dangerous, or do you want them to help greet customers, upsell them, make sure the customers are happy? So Miso's philosophy was, why don't we automate that part of the restaurant in order to help the staff run more efficiently and more safely?
So minimum wage for fast food workers in California is $20 an hour, which is one of the reasons you're gonna be seeing more robotics in restaurants. I made a whole video about that topic. Make sure to check it out, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.
We always want to make sure that human people have jobs, but if there are ways that AI and robots can assist us to do some of the like lower skill level things, then I think that that's always a good thing.
In an attempt to attract workers, wages in the food industry have risen massively. The average hourly wage for non-supervisory roles increased by 8% in 2023, reaching $17.50. But even that has not fully resolved the shortage. Historically, immigrant workers have filled many roles in food production and service, but stricter immigration policies and lower immigration rates have reduced the available workforce. In 2023, the number of immigrants working in food-related industries went down by 15%. Compared to 2019. And younger generations are increasingly avoiding low-wage, high-stress jobs, preferring positions with better work-life balance. This trend has left the food industry struggling to recruit young workers. But hold up, it's not just wages and labor issues here. I meet this restaurant owner who is curious to try this robot burger joint.
In today's world, with the sheer amount of lawsuits that go on, minimum wage going crazy,
there's a lot less risk in terms of workman comp situations. People just are empowered by working with the robots.
What other tasks can robots do? Well, at Chipotle, Flippy's role was expanded to assist with tasks like making tortilla chip, a repetitive and labor-intensive process, which involves cutting tortillas, frying them, seasoning them, and preparing them for serving. Chipotle has emphasized that Flippy is not intended to replace workers, but rather to assist them.
We learned a lot from Chippy. So one of the things that we tested was, it's basically a single unit fryer that cooks chips. And then when we realized it was an innovation lab product, right? So we're kind of testing, hey, does this work? Does this not work? A lot of those learnings were really incorporated into the next version of Flippy.
Wait a minute though. I just did a video about Google's self-driving cars that are navigating the streets of LA and San Francisco without any human drivers. The technology is insane, but then why hasn't burger flipping robotic arms come out yet?
So before it was, oh, I'll hire somebody else and somebody will come wash the dishes and clean the floors. Now, where are those people? How do you find them? How do you make them happy? If they are going to work on this versus driving for food delivery, how do you make it enticing?
Miso Robotics tells me that it's working with other restaurants beyond Jack in the Box and White Castle, but it can't disclose the names because of NDAs. They say it's also getting lots of interest from restaurants in Europe and the Middle East. But what else can robots do?
Right now we have BurgerBot and Tuffy that delivers the food. We have Ecolab dishwasher in the back.
Will people protest or boycott the loss of the jobs that is inevitable with this change?
It's like, well, I don't want to pay for that. And so I think there's still just so much education we have to do for consumers about the fact that, you know, there's a cost associated with making food. We've been very spoiled in the United States to have cheaper food.
We're going to have to find a balance, I think, between being able to pay livable wages for people, but also being able to have like accessible and easy and cheap food.
Will the more than 10 million restaurant workers in the U.S. be phased out of work over the next decade? And should we be concerned?
There's robots in the cooking industry already. They're just kind of behind the curtain. So we're just kind of up in front about the robots that are helping us do our jobs and stuff like that.
Maybe new jobs will be created, and this is just a natural part of technology evolution. The same way farming jobs used to represent half the American population, but today represents less than 1%.
I really don't like talking to people, so I'm kind of like an introvert, but I'm an extrovert if I have to be, and I'd really prefer doing this because I don't really have to be out and about.